back with black coffee, the refill.
Oh, don't pout. Don't pout. Why you pouting? Why you pouting?
On your own poor show. Thing.
Because hands like and feet got put on you verbally.
Huh? You can bring in some puppies.
Yeah, I need some.
Right? That's how you know you lost. She's offering solutions to help you.
I'm fine. I feel fine.
Okay.
Wow. I feel fine. I'd rather talk about something else, though.
Yes, let's talk about you.
Oh, cool.
You are a lawyer.
Yes.
Also, Miss USA, but a lawyer who works in prison reform. So tell us a little bit about that. Like, how do you handle both? And then also, tell me a little bit about what you do in that prison reform space.
Yeah, so I think it was very difficult balancing both. When I was Miss North Carolina USA, before I competed for Miss USA, I did work full-time as an attorney and travel, do appearances and events, and that was very, very hectic. Got very little sleep during that time.
Yeah.
But since I won, I took a one-year leave of absence from the practice of law because being Miss USA is a full-time job, and I have to travel so much. But what was important to me when I started practicing was that I gave back to my community. Mm-hmm. I remember when I graduated from Wake, Brian Stevenson, an incredible attorney and activist, came and spoke shortly after our graduation. And one of the deans at my law school was like, have you read his book, Just Mercy? And I was so embarrassed. I was like, no, I haven't. Is that summer reading?
Yeah.
So I read his book. And when I started practicing, I knew that I wanted to help in the same way that he helped. So that's why I started doing pro bono work.
Right.
And it just took off from there.
That's awesome. And so what I love about this almost like duality that you have is that Miss USA, you almost seem to have to be just world peace and happiness. Like those platforms can't be too deep, right? And prison reform is a controversial topic. Mm-hmm. People have their different feelings about private prisons, all that. So how have you been able to use your platform to kind of elevate the conversation of prison reform?
Well, to be candid, it was something that I was a little concerned about. And so when I was writing my bio, when I was, you know, coming to compete at Miss USA, I just wrote in as like an extra fact about me that, you know, I did work on a pro bono case with my stepdad, who's also an attorney. And I think what was surprising to me was that people were so interested in it. And I appreciated that, that people wanted to know more. And for me, I don't think that you can't have depth in the causes that you care about as a Miss USA contestant. I think that people generally just don't think that we have depth. Mm-hmm. And so they're almost surprised, like, oh, you're a lawyer. Mm-hmm. But I think there were plenty of other contestants. I think, you know, you all said that at some point in time, that there were plenty of other contestants who are incredible women who lead in boardrooms and have to walk into the room and be the person that you're listening to, who work for Fortune 500 companies. Right. And so I loved being around that group of women who are also as accomplished as I am.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful.
Oh, no, on a past episode, we spoke about Kim Kardashian and her activism as far as getting people out of prison and back into society, going up to President Trump and, you know, working things out where they can be out for wrongful convictions or other things. But, you know, we also spoke about the scrutiny that she's faced because people don't necessarily think it's sincere or think that, you know, she has the quote-unquote right intentions because of who she is. What's your stance on that, and can you be an activist in that space and still be someone like Kim Kardashian, who has a hugely popular reality television show that, you know, and also, you know, in some way, shape, or form, people call her a cultural appropriator. So it's a lot. I think it's a very nuanced conversation, but how do you feel about that? Because she is getting, especially black people, out of prison.
Yeah, well, funny enough, one of the cases, I worked on two main pro bono cases while I was an attorney. One of the cases that I worked on was with Brittany Barnett of the Buried Alive Project, who works with Kim Kardashian.
Yeah.
And so hearing from Brittany about the work that she and Kim did and knowing that I got to work on cases sponsored by her Buried Alive Project, that was really important to me and impactful. And I think that we don't always give Kim the credit that she's due and that we demand from celebrities that they know what's going on.
Yes.
We demand that they be good role models. And here one of them is trying to help people who need help. And now we're thinking like, oh, you must be doing this for additional fame. I'm like, no, why can't we just let her do good? And, you know, whatever her intentions are, she's doing good, you know? Right. I think the Buried Alive Project, maybe this year, since Kim Kardashian's been helping them, it's gotten like 20 people released. Mm. One of our clients who I worked for with Brittany Barnett was just released on July 3rd.
Wow.
After spending 18 years of his life in prison. She is doing doing good.
Yeah, that's doing
and
the work.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly. And so regardless of anyone's thoughts on her, she's doing the right thing, and that's more than some people can say.
That's more than most people can say.
Apparently, they're even trying to help ASAP get out. ASAP Rocky. Mm-hmm. Kim and Kanye have apparently now talked to the president.
Yes.
To help.
We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens with that. But I mean, again, the idea of trying to decarcerate, I think, is so important.
Absolutely.
And hopefully we can hear more about you and the work you're doing, and also what your visions for the future are. We got another refill coming up, so we want to do all of that when it comes up.
Great.
All right.
Yay.
Take a sip of water.